नाइन्थ प्रॉब्लम। एवेल्युएट इंटीग्रल कॉस एक्स बाय वन प्लस साइन एक्स होल स्क्वायर डी एक्स। लेट अस एवेल्युएट दिस इंटीग्रल। जस्ट सी द कॉस एक्स इज द derivative of sin x or even derivative of 1 plus sin x. So if you put 1 plus sin x is equal to t, you get 1 by t square dt. Integral of 1 by t square dt is minus 1 by t. So answer becomes minus 1 by 1 plus sin x. So let us do the problem. So let I equals to integral of 1 by 1 plus sin x whole square into cos x dx. Here put 1 plus sin x is equal to t. If you put 1 plus sin x is equal to t, differentiate both sides with respect to x. So we get here this is 0, sin x derivative is cos x, this is dt by dx. Or dt is equal to cos x dx. Now this becomes integral 1 by t square, whereas cos x dx, this cos x dx is nothing but dt. So this is in the form of integral 1 by x square dx is minus 1 by x. The whose derivative of minus 1 by x is 1 by x square. So minus 1 by t. What is t? T is nothing but 1 plus sin x. Let us replace it. So minus 1 by 1 plus sin x plus c. Let us move to the next problem. 10th one, evaluate integral cube root sin x into cos x dx. In this problem, it is very easy to find out the cos x is the derivative of sin x. So put sin x is equal to t. Then this cos x dx becomes dt. This is cube root t dt. Using power rule, we can solve this problem. Now solution. I equals to integral of sin x to the power of 1 by 3 into cos x dx. Take sin x is equal to t, or put sin x is equal to t. If you put sin x is equal to t, differentiate both sides with respect to x. So cos x is equal to dt by dx. So dt is equal to cos x into dx. So now this cos x into dx, sin x, we can write now, this is integral t power 1 by 3. This cos x dx is nothing but dt. Integral x to the power of n dx is equal to how much? That is x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. So what will be the integral t to the power of 1 by 3 dt? This is t to the power of 1 by 3 plus 1 by 1 by 3 plus 1. So this is t to the power of 4 by 3 by 4 by 3, that is 3 by 4. So t is nothing but sin x. So this equals to 3 by 4 times t stands for sin x. Sin x raised to 4 by 3 plus constant of integration. Now let us move to the next problem. That is 11th problem. So now,
11th one,
evaluate integral 2x e power x square dx. Now, how to solve this problem? Just observe, this 2x is the part of the derivative of x square. Since d by dx of x square is equal to 2x dx. So, that means since the derivative of x square is 2x, let us say x square is equal to t, so that this problem can be solved. So, now let I is equal to integral e power x square into 2x dx. Now, put x square is equal to t. Differentiate both sides with respect to x. This becomes 2x dt by dx. Now, dt is equal to 2x dx. Now, this I can be written as integral e power t, whereas this 2x dx is nothing but dt. This is standard result only. So, e power t, integral of e power t dt is e power t. T is nothing but x square. So, e power x square plus constant of integration. Now, let us move to the 12th problem. 12th problem. Evaluate integral e power log x by x dx. So, let us do this problem. What is the value of e power log x? Let us pose ourselves a question. So, e to the power of log x means from logarithms, e to the power of log x is nothing but x. So, x by x cancel, integral 1 dx, 1 is the derivative of x. So, that means integral of dx is x. So, answer becomes x. So, now this is, let us say I is equal to integral e power log x by x dx, whereas e power log x is nothing but x. So, this is equal to integral x by x dx, both cancel 1. So, integral dx is nothing but x plus constant of integration.